Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial dedicated to Premiere Elements 2022, a great video editor offered by Adobe for all beginners and amateurs in video editing. In a very short time, we will see everything you need to know to start using it straight away. Premiere Elements comes with the Adobe Elements Bundle, among Photoshop Elements, to manage and enhance your photos, and Organizer, to manage and categorize your photo collections. All these products are available under a perpetual license for both Windows and Mac OS. If you are also interested in Photoshop Elements 2022, make sure to check our dedicated video tutorial in our playlist. As you open Premiere Elements, its home screen opens, showing several tutorials and articles to go through all its features. It also includes a useful search bar on top if you want to look for something in detail. On the right, you can reopen any existing project made under a Prel file format or go to Video Editor to start with a new one. If you do not have much experience in video editing, the Quick Workspace is the best one. Choose whether to trim any video or combine visual files together to realize your own one. We will go for the second option, as we are going to see the trimming during this tutorial. Select any photo or video to start from. This opens the main workspace with the preview on the center, several buttons on the right, and the imported files at the bottom. You can add further videos, images, and sound files by simply dragging and dropping these next to the added files or clips. These together build your video through several storyboards placed sequentially in time without any overlap. Each storyboard represents a single file with proper thumbnail and duration at the bottom, which is 5 seconds for all photos by default. More at the bottom, you get an independent row for all audio files. With the preview on top, you can check the video in progress. Click and drag above to place the red marker and check any particular frame. Whereas, use the player above or the spacebar key to play back all in real time. Make sure to have at least 8 GB of free RAM memory, or you may get annoying lags. At the bottom, you have several useful buttons, such as Undo and Redo to undo and redo your latest actions made, Organizer to open Adobe Organizer, and Home Screen to reopen the home screen page. Once files are imported, you can go to Create in the top right corner to follow any ready template and realize your video without any effort or experience. In this video, we will see how to make a custom video with the storyboards and all the features inside Premiere Elements. Click and drag any file to move it in position. Right-click on it to cut, copy, or paste it, and use the buttons above to rotate by 90 degrees, auto-reframe videos to remove black bars, or remove any clip. Click on the seconds to adjust the clip duration. On images, you get a simple slider. On videos, you can choose between Smart Trim and Time Stretch. With Smart Trim, you adjust the clip duration by cutting part of its content. Just drag the edges of all the blue borders and create others by clicking on the camera button, selecting all the video parts to be saved. Use Preview to check the result, and then to continue editing to come back to the main interface. Whereas, choose Time Stretch to set the video duration by changing its speed rate, making it faster, above 100%, or slower, below 100%. With the options to reverse the clip and maintain its audio pitch. You can also select any clip and click once on the preview to move, scale, and rotate it directly. This won't work on auto reframe videos. On the right, you can open the Adjustments panel to enhance the selected clip appearance. With Smart Fix, Shake Reduction, and Auto Smart Tone, you can apply automatic corrections on brightness, details, and color tones. Open Color to change the color with Hue, Luminance with Lightness, and Color Intensity with Saturation and Vibrance. Switch to Lighting to correct brightness, contrast, and exposure levels, and use Temperature and Tint to apply great color filters. In all these selections, you can either pick any ready template or go to More to adjust any amount precisely with the sliders. Whereas, click on Reset to revert all the changes applied. When applying any adjustment, this shows a green icon on the right. You can expand it and click on the I button to disable or enable it to check the differences without losing its settings. By default, all these adjustments are applied on the selected clip. Enable Entire Movie on top to add these to the entire video project instead. Open the Tools panel to apply special corrections, including Pan and Zoom or Time Remapping. We won't see these in this beginner tutorial. Below Edit, you can open the Applied Effects panel, showing all the effects affecting the current clip. By default, all videos and images include motion and opacity. The first one transforms the clip by changing its position, scale, and inclination. The second one adjusts its transparency level and adds fade in and fade out transitions to introduce or end the clip by changing its opacity level smoothly. You can add other effects from the effects panel, selecting the proper category on top and dragging and dropping any kind on the clip. Once added, this effect gets listed in the Applied Effects panel, where you can edit its settings while checking the preview. You can manage each effect with the buttons on the right. Use the I button to disable or enable it, the Reset button to revert its properties, and the Bin button to remove the effect from the list. In some cases, you can define masking regions to apply these effects only on limited portions of the visual clip. At the bottom, next to Draw, you can choose how to define such region. Use Pen to draw freehand, clicking on the preview to fix straight segments, and clicking and dragging to drop curves by following the standard Bezier technique. As you close the region, the effect is applied only within such area. Whereas, select circle or rectangle to drop regular shapes that you can move, scale, and rotate by using their nodes. On the right, each region is called selection and can be changed in feather, opacity, and expansion level. Click on Track above to apply an automated motion tracking following the region within the selection made. On the extreme right, click on More to copy the current selection, invert its region, or delete it. Open the Transitions panel to browse and drop amazing visual transitions between two clips, adjusting duration and placement. You can always change the transition effect by dragging another on it. Under Add, you can find free audio samples and loads of text templates divided in motion titles, such as animated text with background, and classic titles, such as simple pieces of text without any motion. Drag any text template to import it as an independent storyboard, or simply select any clip and click on its T icon above to add a simple piece of text that covers the whole clip duration. Very useful if you want to add subtitles. On top, click on the clock icon to set duration and starting point. With the Adjustments panel, apply the right text font, style, size, color, and distribution. Switch to Style to pick any ready text format. Open Animation to add motion, and use Shapes to include multiple shapes and pieces of text together. You can hold down the Control or the Command key to select any element and move, scale, and rotate it as you like. Double-click on any text to type inside instead. Open the Guided workspace to get the complete list of guided effects and corrections you can apply with step-by-step tools and explanations. Check them out! With the Expert workspace, you can build your own video by using a timeline view, which collects files within video and audio tracks instead of storyboards. This is very useful to have multiple clips overlapping at the same time, realizing picture-in-picture effects, and control the duration of any clip or title much better. On the right, you also get audio effects and further video effects, including crop-to-crop clips. To learn more about the Expert workspace, check out our dedicated video in this playlist guide. When your video is ready, you can save it by going to File, Save As. All Premiere Elements projects are saved in a Prel file format, whereas go to Export and Share to render your video. At the bottom, set Video Name and Destination Folder, and select any ready template above for TVs, mobile devices, discs, and social websites such as YouTube or Vimeo up to 4K Ultra HD. With audio or image, you can export just the audio content or the current video frame shown on the preview, whereas go to Devices, Custom to apply your own options for the file format, video resolution, frame rate, and much more. Go to Save at the bottom to start rendering. Thank you very much for watching this video. Visit our YouTube channel to discover more free and outstanding guides.